One of the overarching goals in our lab is to be able to visualize tumors in a live, real environment. Now, that's currently not possible in any real way inside of patients, but we've spent a great deal of time optimizing ways to keep tissue viable outside of patients' bodies. Now, I'll use the analogy of a movie. Now, I could take a snapshot on my phone of some point in the beginning of a movie, some point in the middle, and some point in the end, and you may be able to put generally together what's happened. But seeing the actual movie through would give you so much more insight into what the characters are thinking, feeling, how they're behaving. And that same thing applies to tumors. Being able to watch them in real time gives us so much insight into the tumor biology. And of course, we can give a drug and understand what the drug may be doing and why it may be working or why it may not be working. And these are really demonstrated in these two video clips here. This is an actual gastric cancer, and the red cells are the immune cells. And you can see them sort of running around the tumor cells, really unbothered by the presence of the tumor cells, not killing them like they otherwise should be doing. And then in the second video, you can see that something quite different is happening. You can see we've engaged those immune cells with the presence of a checkpoint inhibitor. And you can see one of the green tumor cells almost blow up because of what that red cell, the immune cell, is doing to it. And this really gives us great insight into what may be happening and why drugs may or may not be working.
U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute, cancer.gov, 1-800-4-CANCER. Produced May 2019.